Hi, my name's Linda Del Greco, and I'm going to talk about my son Alex, who is 18 and a half. He's in Dean College, but where he first started out was at the Pelham Wyndham Preschool. He was diagnosed with autism, which PDD-NOS, which is right in the middle of the spectrum. The preschool was so good. We got information on what we should be doing. Anytime we asked where we should be going for dental, what we should be doing for doctors, they always had someone else that we could go to.
My name is Suzanne Broulard. I'm a mom of two boys, Derek and Ethan, that are 6 and 4 years old. Have had wonderful experiences with both the preschool and kindergarten programs here in Pelham. So the team at the Pelham Wyndham Preschool really became our lifeline for our source of information, tools and resources in the community, things that we could do at home, different techniques that we could follow through with at home that made a big difference for us. We had visuals put into place in our house similar to what was used in the preschool, all sorts of different techniques that we carried through at home. And looking back on the experience that we had, especially during that first year, we realized that the support system they provided was so critical, not only for Derek and his growth, but also for my husband and I and our education and our ability to support him at home as well. And so it really, his success was not only due to the fact that he attended that preschool, but also the education we received to carry that through at home.
I'm the preschool coordinator in Wyndham, and I have been the preschool coordinator for Wyndham and Pelham for 25 years until Pelham Preschool split from the Wyndham Preschool 2 years ago. Pelham has always been a part of the Wyndham Pelham Preschool, and I know many people may not have known that because for most of the time the preschool program was in Wyndham. That the Pelham kids also participated in the program because it was located in Wyndham, but it was actually an SAU-based program, so it was for the two towns. And we've always had to take the space that we were given, which has not always been optimal from an early childhood perspective. The children have gross motor challenges, and they need suspended equipment, and they need large equipment that needs to have a large space. Little kids need to move, and they learn a lot through their movement and their motor activities, and it's really important to have that space for them.
From 1975 to 2009, preschool services were provided at SAU No. 28 Preschool Services Building in Wyndham on Route 111. This facility housed the preschool services for both Pelham and Wyndham. In 2007, Wyndham determined it did not have the space for Pelham students. Since 2009, preschool services for Pelham students have been provided in the portable unit at PES along with kindergarten. The preschool occupies two rooms in this portable unit. Currently, 44 students utilize the preschool service. Preschool services include occupational therapy, physical therapy, and speech therapy. The equipment may be large and requires space for best use. In 2007, New Hampshire directed that all towns must provide kindergarten services by the fall of 2009. Currently, Pelham offers a half-day kindergarten session in the morning and afternoon. The state pays for the first 3 years of renting portable classrooms. The payments stop August of 2012. In the fall of 2010, the school board decided that a permanent solution for kindergarten needed to be passed by the voters. This design shows the placement of their proposed building. It would replace the current portable unit. The proposed building will be a little over 17,000 square feet and will include 10 classrooms plus core space for administration and the nurse. This diagram shows the layout of the proposed building. As you can see, the kindergarten classrooms are contained in one wing of the building, while preschool services are in the other wing. The core space is included in the central part of the school and will service the entire building. The school district already owns the land, and we have been working with the architects to maximize the amount that is reimbursable by the state. Although the exact amount that the state is paying will not be known until the building is constructed, our current estimates are that the state will pay approximately $1.1 million towards this project. Further, the 75% state aid for the kindergarten portion of the building will be paid for upfront to the district. The town will be required to approve the entire amount, but will not need to borrow the total $3.8 million. Here are the budget details for the proposed project. Approximately $3 million are for hard costs, and $800,000 are for soft costs, such as furniture, fixtures, fees, technology, and contingency. 75% of the costs for kindergarten classrooms will be paid for by the state directly. This reimbursement does not include the land or the core facilities. The goal of this project is to comply with state and federal law while providing a cost-effective and long-term solution for Pelham residents. The question is not if we will provide these services, but instead how to best allocate our resources. Under state and federal law, Pelham is required to provide both preschool and kindergarten services. This video was produced by the Pelham School District Communication Committee to provide voters with more information about the proposed preschool and kindergarten building. Thank you for your attention.